In this tutorial video, we're going to learn about the Reshape tool and create a basic paintbrush illustration with it. So you can see the finished product here, and we'll build our new paintbrush on the right-hand side. There are three different tools that we're going to use quite often. The first is the actual basic shapes drawing tools. So if you want to come over here to the toolbar and hit this tear off tab to get this mini toolbar, you should absolutely do that. If you don't want to, it's okay. The other tools that we use are the direct selection tool, and that is up here, it's the white arrow. And then we need to use the reshape tool, which is actually hidden underneath the scale tool, or also where the shear tool might be, depending on what you've chosen the last time you've been in Illustrator. So we need those three tools to create this project. The first thing we need to do is draw out a rectangle for the handle or base of our paintbrush. Now, if you have weird colors in yours, with that object selected, if you just hit D on your keyboard, it will change it to the default colors of a white fill and a black stroke. Now, the tricky thing with the reshape tool is, in order to make it work, you can't have selected it at first with the regular selection tool or the black arrow. So right now, this is actually selected, and I want to change to the direct selection tool and click off to deselect that object, and then click back on the path part of the object so that it knows that we want to alter the different paths of this object. With that done, I need to grab my reshape tool, and then I'm just going to pull down the bottom segment of the path to create the bottom of my paintbrush. And then I can curve the upper part down. I don't want to go too far. And then this outside but upper edge, I want to bulge out, not too crazy, but I want to bulge out. And notice that I'm trying to keep it pretty level with where I click and drag, and then click and drag to pull in the bottom portion. Okay, so tweak that and make it look as best as you can. And once you've done that, grab the rectangle tool again, and we're going to create a rectangle that needs to sit just above the paintbrush here. But we actually want to have it sit behind, so in order to do that, Command or Control left bracket key. And you can hit that left bracket key as many times as you need to get it behind, but it should work if you just do it once. Now, mine is a little bit off in terms of size, so I like to kind of stretch it out and then pull it back in and really look for where those guides line up. Okay, so again, in order to make this curve on this top part of the metal, I need to first grab the direct selection tool, click the path of that object, grab the reshape tool, and now I can drag that path and create the curve. So I want it to look pretty similar to this curve down here. To create the top of the paintbrush, where essentially the bristles would be, we're going to use the oval tool and drag a great big oval out. Now, you don't need to worry necessarily that it's perfectly aligned and perfectly the width, because we're going to alter this. So again, Command left bracket and keep hitting it until it goes to the very behind. Grab your direct selection tool, and remember, you have to first deselect. Because this has been selected already with basically the selection tool, it won't work if you click on the path and then try to use the reshape tool. So deselect first, just in case, then select the path, then grab the reshape tool, and click and drag in to create the top of this paintbrush. And you can tweak it however you think it looks best, and then you can grab this upper portion. Oops. And that looks a little bit weird. So, I don't really like that. Well, it's just being tricky. So, I'm going to go ahead and just drag this out because I want it to actually look like it is coming off the side. So, I might need to nudge it a little bit. And really try to get it to hit those corners. So I don't really like what's happening here, so I might come back later and mess with the reshape and pull it down, pull it out, whatever I need to do. But there's the basic paintbrush that you need to create. So you could sort of rescale this to fit better on your page. And then what I want you to do is actually add some color, but you want to add some depth with some gradient. So I'm going to choose a linear gradient and I'm going to choose my different color stops. So because I want it to look like light, I want it to go from light green to dark green. And the problem is right now it actually just changed that on the outline. So I'm going to change the outline to black. And of course it's not working with me right now. So I'm just going to fill this. Okay. So it's because it was selecting the whole object or just different parts of the object. There we go. Back to normal. So with the fill color, again, linear, and you can change the different color stops. And to show that light, we want to see different shades of the same color. And it's still not doing it. Why isn't it doing it? Okay, I don't know why it wasn't doing that. So again, this one, I would do a gradient, but I would do a light gray and then a dark gray to show that light. And I actually just noticed that I put the shadow wrong out here because the light's hitting it from this side. So make sure you pay attention to that piece of it. And change this to whatever color you want, but in order to do the paint on the top, you might need to create a copy of it. And then you can either take the eraser tool to the bottom down here, or you can even draw a path and then use the divide option on the Pathfinder to create that upper piece that has kind of that, you know, painted drip look, and then put it back on there. So I'm going to go ahead and leave you to do that. And in order to create the shadow, if you copy all of these objects, you can then merge them. And let's see, don't want it to have a stroke. I do want it to have a fill of a light gray for right now. And then what you want to do is either grab the transform controls. So this is where you can actually perspective distort, free distort. So if I do free distort, I can sort of drag these different points out here and really try to distort it. And it's going to look a little bit wonky. There you go. So you can do that. And then you can do the gradient fade, which is going to take it from a light gray or a mid gray to a really light gray or white, so it looks like it fades out. So again, if I do command left bracket, and it'll send it behind it, and then you're good to go. So customize this paintbrush however you see fit. Make sure that you do some gradients for some light, and you know, you might do a little bit of shine on the paint. Maybe you have some paint splatters. I don't know what you want to do, but customize it in some way that you think looks good.